Good afternoon. My name is Lee Howell. I'm the head of global programming here at the World Economic Forum. And if you permit me, I'd like to maybe before the concert begins, make three brief remarks. First, I'd like to give a great vote of thanks to the citizens of Davos, the canton of Graubünden, and of course the citizens of Switzerland for being such great hosts and ensuring that we're enjoying this annual meeting in such safe and warm surroundings. So thank you very much. My second remark is that I want to thank you, the participants, but also my colleagues, my cohorts, the teams that brought this all to life for this 47th annual meeting, and all our partners. So again, a vote of thanks to all of you, participants, teams, colleagues, thank you very much. And lastly, I'd like, well, first let me just say that it's wonderful. This is one of the annual meetings where people really spent so much time to reflect on the theme of responsive and responsible leadership. And I hope by now you've come to your own conclusion or understanding what that would mean to you as you think about and reflect on your experience here at the annual meeting and you embark on your way home. If you haven't, I'll give you a shortcut, a quick definition. It's really about caring and sharing. And you'll see here this evening what that really means. That's the context, really, for so much of what we've been doing together the 4 days, but also what I think is really, for me personally, will be my highlight of my annual meeting, this concert. And I'd like to introduce my colleague, who not only put this concert, but all the arts and cultural efforts to life into the Congress Center and outside the Congress Center. A great colleague, a great friend. I'd like to invite Nico Daswani here to give you a little background, the context for what you're about to experience, which will be truly special. Nico?
Thank you, Lee. Thank you very much. I just wanted to share two things with you. The first was when the Afghan Women's Orchestra, hopefully this will only be now, not later, when the Afghan Women's Orchestra arrived yesterday, one of the conductors, Zarifa, asked me, is Michelle Obama going to be here? And I had to explain to her that Mrs. Obama is probably busy right now moving house. But it was, for me, another realization of the significance of this event for this group, of how much they have practiced. This has been over a period of several months, and how they have brought their entire passion to bring to you this musical offering, to share with you their culture, to share with you their musical traditions. And if you wish to reciprocate that intention, all you need to do during the music is literally to just open your heart and to listen. The second thing I wanted to say was this is an unlikely possibility, and it was made possible because of all the extraordinary partners that came together around this unlikely vision of touring Europe, of bringing the first Afghan Women's Orchestra to tour Europe. And it is really a sort of a model of public-private collaboration with individuals, governments, businesses that came together to mention, of course, the Afghanistan National Institute of Music, Banca Intesa, the Orchestre du Collège de Genève, from Geneva Youth Orchestra. 10 members are here with us tonight and will go on tour. And really, we all came together and we were spurred on simply by the courage that these girls demonstrate. And with this theme of this annual meeting being responsive and responsible leadership, we didn't think there could be any more fitting a closing than an exchange with these extraordinarily courageous musicians. I will just signal that the tour continues, of course. We start here in Davos tomorrow. These musicians will travel and perform in Zurich. They will be in Geneva on Tuesday and Wednesday. They will be in Berlin next Sunday, and then in Weimar the following Tuesday before heading home. So we hope that you will let all of your friends and family know, and so that you can exchange in this special project. That's enough from me. It's now my great honor to invite, for just a few words and to give a little bit of introduction for the concert, the man behind this, the person, the visionary who started the Afghanistan National Institute of Music, who risks his life every day to do what he does, who is a father figure for hundreds of students in Afghanistan. Won't you please join me in welcoming Dr. Ahmad Sarmast.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I know that we all here to celebrate the return of music back to Afghanistan, and also to celebrate the success of this very brave and courageous woman who dared in a very tough circumstances to come forward to form this extraordinary orchestra and to travel as far from Afghanistan to here to show the better side of Afghanistan, to show the positive changes that occurred in the last 14 years in this war-torn country, to show that there's a beacon of hope in Afghanistan, which is called the Afghanistan National Institute of Music, which ensures the musical rights of the Afghan children, Afghan youths, and generally enables the people of Afghanistan to freely and fairly express themselves through music education and an institution that takes every step to tear apart the gender inequality in Afghanistan and to contribute towards peace, stability, better understanding between different ethnic groups of Afghanistan through music, and create a bridge between Afghanistan and the international community, and to change the perception about Afghanistan outside Afghanistan. Afghanistan National Institute of Music, established in 2010, provides co-education for over 200 boys and girls and gives them an opportunity to learn Afghan traditional music and Western classical music. Western classical music, it's while we are significantly and strongly committed to preserve the musical identity of Afghanistan, but equally we are committed to musical and cultural diversity in Afghanistan, and the music that you will be listening this evening, it clearly shows, demonstrates our commitment. I'm not taking much of your time because we're all here to listen to music, to celebrate the return of music, and to celebrate the successful completion of the 2017 World Economic Forum. Given this opportunity, I would like to thank the World Economic Forum for giving us this wonderful opportunity to travel over here with these 30 wonderful musicians, and also enabling us to get intercultural and people-to-people diplomacy with wonderful Swiss young musician from the College of Music from Geneva. And also, I would like all the sponsors and donors who generously contributed to make this project happening here. Good evening, once again, and enjoy the music.
My name is Kevin Bishop, and I have the privilege of being the director of orchestral studies as well as violin teacher at the Afghanistan National Institute of Music. It has been a real pleasure being able to help prepare these girls along with all of my faculty colleagues, although so much of their hard work has been of their own initiative and their own amazing spirit. At ANIM, music flows both ways. Not only do we commit ourselves to preserving and promoting Afghan music, but we also play and celebrate music from all over the world. The next piece that we're playing was specially written for a premiere tonight. This is the first time it'll be performed. And the title, New Dawn, refers to the bright future ahead for Afghanistan thanks to the bravery of young people, such as the 30 young women you see on stage. So please enjoy.
Thank you.
I know that everyone had a very, very long day, and I hope that the music that has been played today contributed to the hot day that you had and give you some relaxation and entertainment. Thank you very much. Your presence here means a lot for us. It gives us full energy so we can go and stand there and with more energy, more commitment, and more hard work. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for the wonderful conductors. Thank you very much, girls, for everyone. Thank you very much, College of Music Geneva. Without you, we couldn't present such good quality sound. Thank you. Today, the performance of this young musician clearly demonstrated how easily music can be understood by every single man and woman of this planet, and how easily through music we can communicate to each other. And the proof is here, how easily these wonderful young people have been communicating in the last few days here, and together, while supporting each other, created this wonderful evening. Thank you very much for everyone for being here this evening. Thank you.